Okay, this is my first recording of blacksmithing, and I'm just recording a bunch of stuff here to see how it goes. I've got, in terms of tools, here's the anvil. I've got my clamps here. And I've also got some pliers right here for work if needed. I've actually just got this, which is why I have this laying around. Sparker and blowtorch. I'm going to be doing attempting to do some blacksmithing on some nails. These are not galvanized, just regular old nails, and I'm just going to see what I can do. I have no idea, I have never done this before. And over here, so this is my dousing bucket, if you will, just a tomato tin. Well, I fill it with water, and then it's on a plate with another tin below it. So that should keep, if anything gets really hot in here, that should keep that from going down too far, and that's on tile. So that should be pretty okay. I am a little worried about doing blacksmithing on this rather wooden area over here, but I don't really have a good solution for that. Actually, I do. I take that back. I'm just going to take a rimmed baking sheet here. These seem to be kind of, oh, there we go. I'm going to place that underneath there, again, just for some extra protection. So, now it's time to try heating this up. And again, I'm just going to give this a try, see what happens. So there's my blowtorch. I don't know if you can see, there we go. So now we're going to take this guy and a nail and see if I can heat that up. I'm going to open that up somewhat. So the job here is just to darken that. All right, at that orange, I'm actually going to re-center here. I'm going to heat that up a little bit more. I'm going to kind of re-center this shot so you can see my anvil fairly well. I'm going to keep on heating this up a bit. And then again, I'm just going to hit it. So the idea here is not to try to get any particular shape, just to try to work the metal. Oh yeah, interesting. I should not have shut that down. Why won't it relight? There we go. Need to heat that up again. But that was surprisingly easy. You just put it on there and just start banging. So now I need to heat it back up again. So the propane, no surprise, to the propane torch here, takes a while to heat things up. It's effective, but it's slow. And I assume I'm gonna go through a lot of propane this way. I'm gonna heat that back up. I'll try to, a little easier for you to see there. You can see some cool little burrs. The next time, definitely a vise would be helpful. All right, let's try working that. And now you can see how that's starting to flatten out. See that? Again, this is just experimentation. But it's definitely doable. And then, theoretically, I could do the same thing to break off the tip there by kind of bending it over the anvil. So the idea is, if I can take the anvil, and sort of bang on it like this, with that nice and hot, that would cut off the tip. So I'm gonna try that. It's all very hot, obviously. Yeah, it's nice and hot. So, and ideally, I can just kind of use that edge to cut it off with. It's not a very hard edge, so that's not too happy, actually. Ah, I'm losing my grip. Hold on. Re-grip it. That's difficult. That's interestingly difficult. Okay. There we go. Need to heat that back up. Nope, it doesn't want to cut off. So I think I'm going to need a cutting blade for this. A special tool. Also, I should probably wait to get it a lot hotter to do that that hitting with. So let's see how hot I can get this in a reasonable amount of time. You can see that bit where I hit is already like a dark red, or even a light red, getting towards orange. But this bit down here is where I really want to hit, because that's where I can make the most damage. That end is pretty hot now. I mean, it's a dull orange. I'm beginning to think also one of the problems is there's only so hot I can make this with the propane. I wonder if that's kind of a limitation. But no, I've seen propane heat things to really hot. I think you just need some time, and you see we're getting some nice stuff on there. That's hot. Now let me keep that on there. Nope, it just doesn't want to come off. But maybe with enough heat, again, it's going to need some definite work. Ideally, you can put a tool on your anvil that acts as a sharp edge. So that little notch at the back is for. You can see how quickly it cools, too. Oops! Alright, I think I've done what I can there. As an experiment, this is very helpful. So as you can see, Maybe you can't. Let's see if we can get a better better angle on this. There we go. So there's my nail. As you can see, I've managed to flatten it a good bit on this part here. I'm keeping very far away from it. This is a you can't see from the distance, but this is, I'm very far away. It's extremely hot. Cutting off that edge is very difficult. It's just not going to be. It's just not very happy. So using these, the edges of the anvil over here, you know, trying to shape it that way, just wasn't working very well. That may be a technique issue, I don't know. But the point is, I certainly got something pretty nice here. So that's a pretty good, you know, pretty decent. There we go. So yeah, so that's okay. So what I'm gonna do now is cool it using my handy dandy little cooling bucket. It lost a fair amount of heat, but that's still a very hot item. It would burn me if I tried to touch it. So yeah, so there's some experimenting with blacksmithing in the home.